She had two sisters, Winnie and Ella Mae. For much of her childhood, Mabel lived with her maternal grandparents, Ella and Henry Pelichet in Marigoan. Mabel graduated from high school at age 15. In December of 1947, Mabel traveled from Louisiana to Inkster, Michigan to visit relatives. While visiting Inkster, she was introduced to Edward Landon Foster. They were married 3 weeks later. Mabel and Edward recently celebrated their 70th wedding anniversary on January 3rd, 2018. 5 children were born to Mabel and Edward: Tanya, Michael, Randall, Carol, and Susan. Mabel was a wonderful mother. She was proud that she and Edward had sent all 5 children to college. She raised all of her children to be Christians and modeled for them how to be a Christian. Mabel and Edward became actively involved in St. Clement's Episcopal Church. Family life for the Fosters was centered around that church. Mabel loved St. Clement's. She loved the beautiful liturgy. She loved the pomp and ceremony of the Anglican Mass. Mabel served on the Altar Guild for 60 years. She sung in the choir for 70 years. Her beautiful singing voice was especially admired during Christmas time. It became a tradition that at midnight mass on Christmas Eve, she sung the African American spiritual, "Sweet Little Jesus Boy." The priest of St. Clemens, whom Mabel had known since the time he was a little boy and had watched him grow up, was dear to her. She often would say, "I have to go help Ellis." In the year 1984, Mabel extended her love of worship by embracing the Seventh-day Adventist Church. She loved that the Adventists spent so much time studying the Word of God. She loved and admired the pursuit of a holy lifestyle that Adventists promoted and lived. Mabel enjoyed the many friends that she made at the Adventist Church. Her heart was gladdened by the sermons of Pastor Liverpool, pastor of Sharon Seventh-day Adventist Church. Mabel had been an elder in the Adventist Church. She was also a charter member of Operation Reachback, an organization dedicated to the holistic enhancement of Black communities. Mabel Foster was a Christian in the tradition of Christians who lived during the first century. She believed in sharing whatever she had with others, demonstrating the fruits of the Spirit seemed to come naturally to her. In her professional life, Mabel worked 20 years for Inkster Housing Authority as a manager. She loved being able to place people in homes who were homeless. She loved helping the many families she encountered develop stable lives by giving them a home. In the community, Mabel was active in trying to make Inkster a better place to live. She was a good neighbor who touched many lives. She was on the board of directors for Chateau Cherry Hill. She also served on the board of St. Clemens Housing and Inkster Housing. Mabel was survived by her husband Edward, 4 children, 7 grandchildren, 9 great-grandchildren, and 2 great-great-grandchildren. Mabel Foster was the rarest of persons. We loved her kindness, her generosity, her compassion, and the great love she had for the Lord. She was grand. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall live.
On behalf of the Reverend Father Ellis Clifton, Jr., Ranked Director of the Episcopal Church of St. Clement Rome, our Wardens and Vestry, our New Visions Coordinating Committee, and St. Clement's entire parish family, I bring you greetings in the name of our risen. come together in faith, even in the midst of shared grief, to praise and give thanks to God for the many blessings he has bestowed upon us. Today, we are gathered together to thank him for the blessings given to us and our sister in Christ, Mabel Foster. Mabel Foster has the distinction of being a pillar of the church, as she was in the second wave of members on the book at St. Clement's Church. With her death, St. Clement's has no more of those first two groups of believers that are considered to be the founders of our parish. Still, if her legacy is properly honored, even in death, she will still be a pillar of our Christian community.
Amen.
There are many things that we can thank God for that were given to both of our communities of faith through Mabel Foster. One of many is her attribute as a prayer warrior. We have a group in our congregation called Prayer Partners. Mabel was not a consistent member of the group, but when she was with them, she had the ability to influence the group for the good. You felt it when she prayed. When she prayed, you consciously or unconsciously prayed with her. She was a prayer partner. Father Clifton recalled a situation where both he and Mabel were concerned about the direction the discussion was going at the church. Neither Mabel nor he could recognize from where the thoughts of some of those who were being argued were coming. Both she and Father Clifton had an epiphany when someone said, "You were talking about the way it used to be. What we are talking about is the way we want it now." Father Clifton responded with one of his favorite responses, that we should embrace change but remain true to our core values. Mabel Foster reminded everyone that Christianity would not have remained a viable influence in the world if we got to change it whenever we want. Then she began to recite the words of an old Christian standard. Faith of our fathers, holy faith, we will be true to thee until death. The discussion, which had become quite contentious, did not suddenly cease, and the mood of the room did not change immediately, nor did the group make an immediate decision. But the seeds were planted in those who were open to the historic faith of our fathers. When the discussion was finally made, the rationale was biblically based, and it reflected the traditional intent of activity in that area. The point of the story is this. When we thank God for the gifts that were given to both of our communities of faith through Mabel Foster, we can thank him for this. Mabel Foster appreciated and defended the intent of the historic faith. Sometimes change was difficult for her, and it took prayer and time for her to adjust. But if the change reflected the intent of the historic Christian faith, she was okay with it and would do what she could to support. We need more champions of the historic faith of our church in today's world. Finally, we celebrate the spirit of Christian hospitality she brought to the community of faith. There were times at St. Clement's when it seemed as if there were no strangers to her. She knew or knew of everybody, and everybody knew or knew of her. She could go from cheerful to compassionately concerned, and then back to cheerful very quickly. And times together could be fun, pastorally sensitive, thought-provoking, and or common, all in the same city. Those times spent with her in prayer and fellowship could be affirmations of that, which is found in our baptismal covenant when we are asked, "Will you continue with the apostles' teaching and fellowship in the breaking of the bread and in the prayers?" When we respond, we will with God's help.
Amen.
There are so many things I can say about Mabel Foster, but it would be redundant. Her sermon has been preached by Pastor Liverpool and Father Clifton. It was preached by her in the way in which she lived her life. It can continue to be preached in her legacy. On behalf of St. Clement's Parish family, thank you for allowing me these words. Thank you, God, for the ministry of Mabel Foster. Amen.
Amen.
My name is Commissioner DeSalla. I am here today to formally present this resolution to the family and friends of Mable Hawkins-Foster to commemorate her long and dedicated service to the Inkster Housing Commission and the Board of Commissioners and the residents of the community. Before presenting this resolution, please allow me to say, without getting emotional, I had the blessed opportunity to meet this incredible human being at Ernestine Carter's 30th retirement celebration from Inkster Housing Commission. I was among one of the guests sitting alongside Miss Hawkins Foster at her table. And we laughed, we joked, small talk, and just in that short amount of time, you know, I mean, you could just feel, you know, in the spirit realm that this woman was something, wow, something awesome. So I am truly blessed to have that one in a lifetime experience to be among Miss Hawkins Foster and her presence. Allow me to say, Mable Foster leaves a legacy to our Inkster Housing community. She was a pillar example of faith in action because every resident she served at Inkster Housing Commission was treated with the utmost respect and courtesy. It was as if she was offering a Christian-like service of dedication and unselfishness of herself to each person, that's friends or strangers. She was loved by many and will be truly missed for many years to come. So now on behalf of Commissioner Carolyn Smith, Chair of Inkster Housing Commission, the Reverend Commissioner Ellis Clifton Jr., Vice Chair, Commissioner Mabel Strohman, Treasurer, the Reverend Commissioner George Williams, Board Member, Attorney Linda Bernard, our Executive Director, and of course myself, Resident Commissioner DeSalla Scott, I offer this resolution as it reads, Resolution in Memory, celebrating the life of Miss Mabel Hawkins Foster. Whereas Mabel Hawkins Foster was a highly respected leader in the city of Inkster, employed for 20 years as a manager at the Inkster Housing Commission, and as a commissioner on the board of the Inkster Housing Commission. And whereas Mabel Hawkins Foster loved serving the people of Inkster and placing homeless people in housing, she loved helping the many families she encountered develop stable lives by providing them with a home. And whereas Mabel Hawkins Foster was an active and current member of the Sharon Seventh-day Adventist Church as well as the St. Clement's Episcopal Church, she loved both pastors, Pastor Liverpool, as well as Father Ellis Clifton, and remained a faithful member serving on the altar guide for 60 years and a devoted choir member for 70 years. And whereas Mabel Hawkins Foster was active in trying to make Inkster a better place to live, she was a good neighbor who touched many lives. She served on the board of directors for Chateau Cherry Hill Retirement Housing and on the Vassery of St. Clement's Episcopal Church. And now, therefore, be it resolved that the Inkster Housing Commission honors the life of Mabel Hawkins Foster for her service to the Inkster Housing Commission and the city of Inkster. Her dedication to improving the lives of citizens and her steadfast commitment to making Inkster a better place to live. And further, now, resolved that the Inkster Housing Commission Board of Commissioners, staff, and residents collectively express our deepest condolences to the family, friends, and colleagues of Mabel Hawkins-Foster. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be present to the Hawkins-Foster family on the occasion of the memorial service to be held in honor of Mabel Hawkins-Foster at the St. Clement's Episcopal Church on February 12, 2018. As I close with this statement, again, on behalf of the Inkster Housing Commission, Board of Commissioners, and the residents of Inkster Housing, you have our deepest heartfelt prayers and condolences. If we can be of any service, of comfort to you during this time of grief, please do not hesitate to contact us. Thank you.
Oh, when the saints,
oh, when the saints
go marching in,
oh, when the saints go marching in.